Plants are vital to human survival. They provide the air we breathe, they provide the shelter, they provide our clothing, they provide our medicines. There's nothing that plants don't provide us with. None of us would be here without them. I'm Dr. Eleanor Bremen. I'm a senior research leader in seed conservation here at the Millennium Seed Bank. Seed banking has never been more important than it currently is. Our conservation efforts on the ground are not going to be enough to secure a future for wild plants.
Evidence of climate change is there. Hotter, drier summers, some cases wetter winters. So our farmers are having to grow crops in increasingly difficult situations. My name is Chris Cockell and I'm the coordinator of the Adapting Agriculture to Climate Change project, also known as the Crop Wild Relatives project. The point of the Crop Wild Relatives project is that we collect the seeds of the wild relatives and then through the process of traditional crop breeding, they will try and improve the domesticated crops to make them more adaptable to changes in climate or pests and diseases. If you can breed some of those important genetic traits back into their domesticated crops, then you can make them more resistant to drought stress, heat stress, or even flooding.
Global food security is a huge issue at the moment. We're reliant on very few species of crops for all of our nutritional intake. 90% comes from only 15 crops. They're very vulnerable to the impacts of climate change. We really need to diversify not only the sources of our food, but also how we grow them. We're buying time, really.
In some cases, domestication of crops has taken place tens of thousands of years ago. For instance, the cereals. Wheat was domesticated as long ago as 10 or 15,000 years ago. We've recently started talking about collecting forage crop wild relatives. And so forage is what livestock eat. And so if you can collect the wild relatives of those crops, you can make livestock breeding more sustainable in terms of carbon capture in the soil, in terms of methane emissions, so that there are other areas that we can work in to secure crop wild relatives. One of the problems with crop breeding is that it takes time, like 10 to 15 years to develop a new crop variety. So we're really playing a game of catch-up, if you like, to try and capture this genetic material before it's lost forever. Potentially there's material out there that has already been lost.
We have a treasure trove of species conserved. Collections range from the Arctic to the Antarctic to 5,000 metres in the Himalayas. We have 6 underground vaults which currently conserve 40,000 species. We focus on the wild plants which make up around 99% of plant diversity. We go out and collect these seeds from the wild populations and then we're storing them, protecting them for future generations. When the seeds arrive here, we dry them down to a safe humidity for them to be frozen. And we put them into a sealed container and then put them in our seed vault, which is at minus 20 degrees. Our 6 vaults are situated below ground. They're floodproof, bombproof, radiation-proof, and they're highly secure. We've had seed collectors go out on trips and they've arrived and they've been too late. That plant didn't exist there anymore. So we have a pressing need to get there now. Our conservation efforts on the ground are not going to be enough to secure a future for them. We have to take them into safekeeping until such time as we can maintain those habitats and return them to them. I think exciting areas moving forward at the seed bank is increasing that use of our collections and making sure more traits are discovered and are out there to help people. We also want to increase the use of collections for restoration activities, and we've got plans here for a conservation and research nursery, which is going to help us do that. But we also do need to continue to conserve it ex situ in places like seed banks so that we can buy that vital time to restore ecosystems to equilibrium and then put plants back into a safe space.
These seed collections are vital for the future.
Within this store, we have the answers to the next agricultural revolution or to the next disease resistance. There's all kinds of properties that these plants possess that we don't even begin to understand. We can't not act now because they won't be there tomorrow.